The appointment of this council, the members are appointed by the government through the trade ministry, and it's not a council where members can join in. We work on integration between ASEAN and India as a think tank, and also to see what are the prospects of ASEAN moving forward in India. As we always seen and heard of our figures, ASEAN is the one of the fastest growing economies in the world, with a GDP is about 6.8%. India is at 6.8% and ASEAN is about 5.6%. Figures clearly show that in this decade, ASEAN and India will be the champion of growth. Having said that, what are we doing about it? What advantage are we taking about it? And how are we going to move forward? Figures prove that. We also see another thing happening within ASEAN and India, that we have the youngest growing population. 60% of the population between ASEAN and India is a young population. When you have a young population, you have to look forward and see what you can do for it. When you have an older population, which also is growing, we have to see what we can do for the old population. For having a choice of taking care of the young and looking after the old, we have a lot of opportunity on the basis where trade is concerned. We must not forget that 60%, 95% to 97% of the SMEs are actually in the economic pie. And out of this, 60% are SMEs. So what do we do about it? We have to start looking what we can do for the SMEs. And if you look at ASEAN and India, they have got a number of SMEs which have to be linked together. And that is where we would like to play a very important role to see that how we can integrate trade between ASEAN and India where the SMEs are concerned. Having said that, what can the SME do? SMEs usually are called them, they are usually handicapped. We need to help them. We need to push them. And how do we do it? AIBC has taken an agenda to see that we create forums, we create links for SMEs within ASEAN and India. We also try to work with various state governments in India and governments in ASEAN to see how they can promote these SMEs. India has got a very specific agenda for the Northeast states with ASEAN, and Prime Minister Modi has always focused that he wants to integrate the Northeast states of India with ASEAN. I'm happy and proud that Laos has started their job to see how this can be done. This is the first event which AIBC in Laos have today. 25 years is a long way off, and I'm sure if we start moving forward, we'll have a lot of opportunity. Coming back, what can we do? India has got a huge potential for tourism, and tourism is a landmark thing which India can integrate with ASEAN. Little unfortunate where connectivity is concerned, we lack connectivity between ASEAN and India. Surprisingly, Singapore, Malaysia and Thailand have got good air connectivity with India. Unfortunately, Philippines does not have one flight per day to India, it has none. Brunei doesn't have connectivity with India by flight. Neither, yet Air Malindo has started a flight from Indonesia via Kuala Lumpur. So this clearly proves that a lot of things are yet to be done. And we, in AIBC, have always been focusing with all government meetings, with the AEM at the ASEAN meeting, we have said that we have to move, first the connectivity must come up. If not, we don't see it happening. Trade can only take place when people start visiting places. Businessmen must see what opportunities they have in another land. Now, the connectivity within ASEAN is very conducive. We look towards it in time to come that the connectivity between ASEAN and India would be there. And I'm very sure efforts taken by the Chief Minister of Manipur being here present today clearly proves a point that the Northeast states do want to be here. They have come up to see how we can integrate. Connectivity does not only mean transport. Connectivity also means financial connectivity. How do we get FDI moving across? Everyone gets worried in a new place. But I think there is opportunity. Connectivity does not mean only finance. It also means cultural connectivity. We have to link with each other with culture so that we can improve our relationship. So AIDC is taking this agenda, and I'm very sure we will achieve it. Today is the 25th year of the ASEAN India as a Dialogue Partner. Last meeting in Vientiane, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi was here, we actually requested at an AEM first before the leaders meet that ASEAN should have a forum and an expo every year. So we are pleased to announce that the last expo and forum was just held in Bangkok. I believe that many, some of you would have been there. It was a tremendous success. I hope that this ball will roll on to other ASEAN countries, and I'm sure that India is also focusing to have an expo next year. I think smaller businessmen who need to take advantage of this can go for the expo, can get linked with the smaller businessmen and move forward. I would like to advise the Laotians here that please be in link with any of the Indian state government. India has come up with a lot of websites where you can get a lot of information of trade within India. Please go through it, and I'm sure that you will find something for yourself. At this point of time, I would also like to thank Mr. Habib, who has actually taken a lot of pain and initiative to see that this event happen. And his company, HSMM, has actually sponsored this event for the conference and dinner. I would like to thank them, because I believe that without funding, things don't move. And with funding, everyone must support the system. And if we want AIBC to work forward for all of us, we must all support it. AIBC is not a platform. Please remember, AIBC is not a platform for only India. It's a platform for members of that country. AIBC is a platform of Laotians, Indians who are based in Laos, and every other country. So let's look at it that all of us present here must support the system, support the platform, try to take advantage of the platform. Please try to ask what you need for information from this platform, and let's move together. With that, I would like to thank each and every one of you for being present here today. It gives me a great pleasure. Thank you.